So when there's more than one way of doing something, well, of course, we have to decide if you're implementing an operating system or something like that, should I go with ACLs or should I use C-lists? I said most operating systems use access control lists, but some were done capability-oriented or capability-based. So there must be, some pros and cons. One must have some nice things that perhaps the other one doesn't offer. And then you have to see what is more important to you. And based on that, you're going to make a decision. Let's look at a couple of these possibilities, metrics that you perhaps can use to decide whether you want to go with ACL or C-list-based implementation of access control. Okay, so first thing, we always worry about efficiency. So in this context, I said a couple of things when you're talking about implementation with ACLs and C-lists. With ACL, I said you have to traverse the list. You have to go down the list looking for an access control entry or ACE for the user who made the request. Traversing a list is, there's some processing overhead required, isn't it? CPU time it's going to take. Capability list, I said it's a handle, shouldn't be able to force it, but once you have it, it's been propagated to you. You present it to the system, and system knows that by mere possession of this capability, you should be able to access the resource. So when it comes to efficiency, C-list is faster. We don't need to traverse anything, but ACLs have this negative thing where we have to go down a list. So efficiency, you would say C-lists are better. But let's look at another thing that's good to have, and that's accountability. So let's say if I ask you, who all have access to this sensitive file? With ACLs, what you're going to do is you're going to find the ACL, you go down the access control list, and you have every user and what kind of access they have for this file. So information about who can access this file is available. All of it is available in one place, which is the ACL. So ACLs are actually good when it comes to accountability because we can go look in one place and be able to answer that question. How about C-list? Remember, we said C-lists are stored either in objects or catalogs for different users and so on. So to find out who all have the capabilities, who are all the users who hold a capability for a resource, I have to look in every user catalog. I have to look into every object that may store this capability, for example, if we want the capability to be used from that particular object. So now accountability is going to be hard because, as you said, we may have to look at all catalogs and things like that. So C-lists are not so great when it comes to accountability. Revocation is essentially you gave someone permission to access a resource, but in the future, you don't need to share the resource with them anymore. So at that point, you want to revoke their access, remove their access. With ACL, how can we do it? So let's say Alice decides to revoke Bob's access for file foo. Well, it's easy. We know that there's an ACL for foo. And Alice makes a call to the system saying, remove Bob's permission. The system locates the ACL, finds the ACE for Bob, and in there removes whatever permission that's being revoked. So with ACL, revocation is actually easy. Okay? They have this desirable positive property because we know how to go turn off the access right in the ACE, and all the ACEs are in one place. How about C-list? How do we revoke with capabilities? Well, that's interesting. It's actually hard because we know the capability sits in Bob's catalog. Now, Alice can't go remove capabilities from Bob's catalog at will. How exactly does she do it? There are interesting ways in which you may be able to do it and things like that. But with C-list, actually, revocation is not easy. So if you look at accountability, of course, C-list look better. But if you look at efficiency, C-lists look better. But if you look at accountability and revocation, ACLs look better. So there are obviously these trade-offs we have to worry about. And because of that, I said most operating systems actually choose to go the ACL route. But we're going to see how maybe we can get the best of both worlds.